Hi, I'm Diane with Worth Beyond Rubies, and today I'm going to be talking to you about a topic that is really important to me and should be important to all believers, and that is the importance of guarding your heart and your mind and setting a watchman to guard against the enemy. For anyone who's followed me for any period of time, you may know that I have gone through a series of health issues really over the past 2 years, but it's actually progressively gotten worse over the last year. And when you have health problems, they can really weigh on you, not just physically, but emotionally. And many times when you're struggling with pain or you're struggling with feeling sick and you can't do the things that you enjoy, it can cause you to feel oppressed. It can cause you to feel depressed emotionally. And that's what was going on in my life. There were two things that I really enjoy in my life when I'm not feeling well and can't really get out and do as much as I would like. And those two things are, I have a window seat in my living room, and out in my front yard, I had these flowers and plants and hummingbird feeders. And I have a window seat in this little alcove, and I love to sit on my window seat and I love to watch the hummingbirds. It's one of my favorite things to do. I love my hummingbirds. I look forward to them every year. And the other thing I love to do is when the sun is shining, I love to go out on my deck. I open up my awning. I'll sit with my laptop and I'll work out there. I have a little fence, a little gate that I put up on my deck, and my dog can come out there with me, and I just love sitting out there. But what's happened recently is we live in an area where we have a lot of black bears. And what's happened recently is in my front yard, and this has never happened in all the time that we've lived here, in my front yard, a bear came and took out one of my hummingbird feeders. And unfortunately, what that meant was I then had to take down the other hummingbird feeders that were in the front yard because we didn't want this bear was tagged. So we know from our neighbors and everyone in our town, we all talk about the bears when we see them because we do enjoy them, surprisingly enough. We do enjoy seeing the bears, and we compare the numbers of the bears that we see in the yard, and we say, oh, you know, we know her. She has a couple of cubs. And this one female bear does have a couple of cubs, but she was by herself this one day. And so we didn't want her to come back knowing that there were other feeders in the yard. So we took them down. So then this was followed up with a very long series of rainstorms. So what this rain did was all the pretty flowers that I had out in the front, they died off from getting flooded. So I no longer had my hummingbird feeders to look at, and I couldn't see my hummingbirds, and there were no flowers. And so I would sit at my window seat and it would kind of look dead and kind of depressing. And the sun wasn't out. And when you go through cloudy periods for a long time, very weather driven, it can make you feel sad. And with all the rain and everything going on, I couldn't even sit out on my back deck. We have a little birdhouse on our deck where these little tiny birds come every year, and they lay their eggs, and I get to sit and they trust me for some reason. Well, I shouldn't say for some reason. They trust me because I don't bother them. But they hatch these little baby birds, and so I sit at the deck while I'm working and I hear the little baby birds chirping, and the mama bird is bringing back worms and everything for the babies. And it's so amazing to see. What I love about our yard is that I get to see all of creation just kind of come alive in the spring and summertime, and I love it. But then all of it for a while, especially during one of the worst times that I've had physically, was taken away. And I allowed myself, and I use the word allowed myself, to feel depressed and feel emotionally oppressed, because I can feel the enemy. The reason why I say oppressed is because I can feel the enemy just putting this weight on me. And one of the things that I realized during this time was that I was relying on these external things to give me joy and give me peace instead of relying on God. I was relying on the sunshine and the birds and the plants and the baby birds out back. And I was relying on all of this to give me my joy. And what I was not doing was I was not guarding my heart and my mind, because all these things that I'm speaking of are all about my thoughts and all about my feelings, how the hummingbirds made me feel, how sitting outside made me feel. It was all about my thinking and my feelings. And our faith and our happiness and our joy, and I don't like to use the word happiness because it is a feeling, and happiness can be very fleeting. And I wrote a blog post on that as well, because happiness, we sometimes gauge where we are in life based on what makes us happy. But what makes us happy today may not make us happy tomorrow. I know a lot of people who have a lot of money, and you know, we often hear the term money can't buy happiness, and it's true. Because they may be happy initially, but then there are other problems that come with that. And so I try not to use the word happiness, but I'm using it here for lack of a better word. I wasn't finding my joy, and what I wasn't doing was I wasn't setting a watchman to guard my heart and my mind. And what's a watchman? And I'm sorry for the I do love birds. I did say that, and I do have a couple in the room here with me, and they love to chat when I'm talking. So I apologize. But so in ancient times, when they would have these walled cities, they would set a watchman on the wall of the city to look out. This was kind of like a lookout to see if the enemy was approaching. And when they would see the enemy approaching, they would warn their commanders and they would warn the people of the city that the enemy was approaching. And then what they would do is they would either form an offense and go out and attack the enemy before the enemy can get near the city, or they would form a defense and they would defend their city. They would set up armies around the walls of the city and defend the city. And this watchman was so vitally important because it allowed the people of the city to have a sense of peace. They knew that somebody was watching out for them. They knew that somebody was on guard and would warn them when the enemy approaches. And when we focus on the things in our life that make us happy, when we focus on the things of life that are quite honestly fleeting, you know, like I said, the sunny weather makes me feel a certain way, but I can't rely on it being sunny every day. So what happens when it's not? I have to rely. You know, the Bible says the joy of the Lord is my strength. And I wasn't finding that joy because I wasn't looking for it. I was looking in other places. And what happened during that time was I let my watchman take a break. And there was nobody guarding the walls of my heart. There was nobody guarding the walls of my mind. And the enemy got in, and the enemy was able to make me feel depressed, feel like, you know, life was never going to get better. I was always going to be in pain. And it made me feel like I just, even things that were enjoyable, you know, my husband would say, let's go to a baseball game, and I wouldn't feel like going. And the enemy will come in and take over the minute you let that watchman take a break. The minute you let that watchman go, the enemy will come in and ravage your mind and your heart the minute you fail to set a watchman over them. And so it's vitally important that we realize that we don't get our happiness and our joy from the things of this world. We get our happiness and our joy from the Lord. And that we need to always, always be sure that we know what's getting in to our spirit, that we know what's getting into our city, that we set that watchman to warn us, to say, hey, the enemy is approaching. You need to either form an offense and defeat him before he gets there, or if it's kind of late in the game, to form that defense and pray and rely on God to fight that battle for you, because now you've come up against the enemy face to face and you are in a battle. And we need to rely on the Lord. We need to take every thought captive. And it's so important that during times like I'm going through with my health, and times where I'm just allowing things, and we're going to get there from time to time. I'm not going to lie to you. There's going to be times that even as believers, we don't do what we're supposed to do. I know that sometimes when I feel physically worn out, praying can seem like such a daunting task. And I'm not going to pretend that, you know, we're all super spiritual and there are times and we just pray all the time. No, it doesn't work that way. When we're worn out, when we're tired, when we're in pain, when we're going through a chronic illness, sometimes you don't have it in you. And that's when we need to rely on God and rely on that watchman. Because that's when the enemy is going to come in. The enemy is going to see those little openings and come in and try to make us feel worse. Try to take us down. Try to make us reject God. Try to make us question God. Why am I going through this? Why am I suffering? And also cause us to rely on the things of this world for our happiness and our joy. So set a watchman. Always be in prayer. The Bible tells us how to do this. Put on the full armor of God and stand against the enemy. He does not stop. He doesn't take a vacation. He doesn't sleep. The Bible tells us that he prowls around like a lion seeking whom he can devour. We need to always have a watchman set. We need to always be in the Word, always be in prayer. And if you don't feel like praying because you're worn out, and I am with you, then we know that the Bible tells us that we can cry out and the Holy Spirit will intercede for us when we don't have the words. But we need to cry out. We need to, even if we have no words, sit and cry and sit in his presence. And just ask him, Lord, I've got nothing right now, and I need you to come and set a watchman for me. So I hope that this was helpful to you. If you're not viewing this on the post, please go visit the post on Guarding Your Heart and Mind. I will link it below. And please subscribe. I have not recorded videos in some time because of my health. But I am starting to get out there now and start recording them for you. So please subscribe so that you don't miss any of them. And I will talk with you soon.